Very good morning to all the lovely students of class 10th D. I hope after vacation you are in good spirits and good health. And kindly switch on the videos. Before starting the chapter, I'm going to ask, as I always do, I know. I always ask one question to you people, then I start the chapter. Fine? So I want you to speak. I would be unmuting any one of you and you will be speaking. You know that you have done that writing skill of diary entry. You have done, fine, diary entry, you know how to write diary. So you just tell me how many of you have made an entry in diary or you have written your own personal feelings in a diary. Just raise your hand. I would be unmuting you. Have you felt that I need to write a diary? Sometimes you feel very happy. Sometimes you feel very lonely. Sometimes you are not able to share your feelings with anyone. Daksh, your phone is not settled yet. Raise your hand. Bisam, you have not written a diary. Divyansh, Harsimran, Parihina, never. Okay, so you tell me, why do we write diary? I change my question. If you have not written, you tell me, why do we write diary? Now raise your hand. Very easy question. Okay, Bisam, you can speak. You have raised firstly your hand. Yes, you can speak. Unmute yourself.
To express some incidents.
Can you speak loudly?
To the diary. To express some incidents.
To express?
Some incidents.
Okay. Now, who wants to speak next? Anybody else? Anybody else would like to answer the same question? Why do we write a diary? Parina, tell me. Okay. Tanya is raising hand. Okay, Tanya, you can speak better.
Ma'am, whenever we feel lonely or not in a mood to talk to someone, then we usually write diary.
Yes, very good. So Tanya is saying whenever we are feeling lonely, whenever we are not feeling good, we are feeling low, fine, then we write diary. So let me tell you why we write diary. So many of you joining. Let them come. To share our feelings, Harsimran is sending me the message. So, yes, diary writing is actually a piece of writing in which there is no particular rule to be followed. You have to be very informal because just like the way you talk to your friend, you write your expressions whenever you're feeling lonely, whenever there is no one to share your feelings with, fine. So in that way, you start writing diary. Okay, let me discuss my viewpoint with my diary. Let me tell what I want to convey. Fine. Bisam, kindly have the decent pictures, okay? The students who are displaying their pictures, kindly have decent pictures. Fine. Don't put your filtered pictures over here because we are in school setting. Okay, this is not your personal thing. Yes, Princy saying writing a diary makes an inanimate object a mode to which we can express ourselves. Yes, you can express yourself properly and there is no fear of anyone. Sometimes we are so scared if I will tell this thing to my parent or my friend or my teacher, so he or she might react in another way. Fine. So diary, when we write a diary, we can write anything, whatever we feel like. Now, this chapter, very beautiful chapter, you will be relating yourself with this, a teenager girl who's just 13 year old and she starts writing diary because she has many people around, but no one with whom she can express her feelings. Fine, because this is the stage when a lot of hormonal changes are there in your body. When you want to talk to someone, you want to express yourself, but people are not able to understand you. Fine, adolescence age is that, you can say, upside down. A lot of changes are there emotionally, physically, mentally, socially. So you need to express. If you keep on suppressing your emotions, you might be depressed at one point. You should have one person to talk to whom you trust, whether it's your mother or father or any friend or teacher. Or if you do not have any friend to talk to, you start writing. At least you will express your emotions. Clear? So let's start with the chapter. Board is visible to all of you. I have written one quote. Harsimran, can you speak this quote louder? Harsimran, unmute yourself. Your brother is busy extracting the things out. So you can speak, Harsimran.
Yes, hard work never goes unrewarded.
Yes, hard work never goes unrewarded. I don't know, I'm just getting very low voice from you people. That can be some technical issue. Hard work never goes unrewarded. That girl, that 13-year-old Jewish girl, she starts writing or she starts noting down her expressions in the form of a diary. And she was not knowing that one day that diary would be published at global level, at universal level. People would be loving his book, her book, sorry. Fine. So hard work never goes unrewarded. She never started writing by thinking that she would be publishing it, because that was quite personal. Personal account of someone's life. But a very, you can say, tragic incident will happen. I won't be disclosing what happens. And then she became a writer at very young age. Until date, we are reading her chapter in the NCERT book. Earlier, we were having complete book beta. From the diary of a young girl is actually a book written by, it's a kind of a journal only. Journal is a, you can say, sequence of your experiences or recordings. When you start recording your personal experiences, it becomes a journal only. So it's a journal written by, in the form of diary entry, by a 13-year-old Jewish girl named Anne Frank. What is the name is written in the title itself. Fine. So we would be reading about, before that I would be introducing you the characters. Fine. Anne Frank, she's the protagonist, main character of the story. Fine. And her full name was Annalisa Mary Anne Frank. Fine. It's not Annalise, it's Annalisa. The pronunciation is Annalisa Mary Anne Frank, her full name. But we would be calling her Anne Frank only. Then we have Margot Frank. She's the elder sister of Anne Frank. Fine. And then Otto Frank, her father, Anne Frank's father, Otto Frank. Then we have Edith Frank. Edith Frank is the mother. Apart from these four characters, we are having more characters also. But I would be, today it's enough for you to know about the family of Anne Frank. Because I would be just narrating these value points to you only today. So you kindly take notes. 13-year-old Jewish girl. She belonged to Jew community. The way we are Punjabis, Punjabi community in that way, right? She belonged to Jew community and she records her experiences or daily experiences. Named her diary Kitty and treats it as her best friend. She not only, you know, writes diary, she actually treats her diary as her best friend because she was feeling very lonely. There were people around, but she was not able to express. So she started writing diary and named her Kitty. And she would write, dear Kitty, hello Kitty, hi Kitty. In that way, she would narrate her experiences. Then Anne's first entry in the diary. Maybe we won't be able to complete or whatsoever. These points I will try to cover. Fine. Characters are clear to everyone. Points are clear to everyone. Now I would be telling you what is the background of this story. So we would be, I would be sharing the screen for this. Okay, you can have your books with you. Yes. Is it clear? Yes, beta. Can you see it? from the diary of Anne Frank, chapter number 4. Before you read, this is the girl. She died at very young age. She was just 16. She wrote a diary for 2 long years when she was just 13. And what happened, why she died, everything we would be reading in detail, fine? And what is the background and why she started writing diary, let me tell you that. Firstly, you should know the time she wrote the diary, that was the time of beta, I must tell you, World War II, clear? So World War II was going on, and their country, their place was invaded by Nazis. When one country invades the other country or other place, what they do is they start, you know, a kind of thing that people of the country, they are not able to go out, they're not able to move out. Riots start taking place, they start killing them at any time. So what happened, because at that time, Nazis invaded and all the Jews people, the people of Jew community, J-E-W, you must know it, this should be very much clear to you, the background. All the Jews were being sent to Nazis concentration camps. Now, what are these concentration camps? Where all the Jewish people were being, you can say, kept as slaves, you can say. So they were forced to go there in concentration camps. They were searching for Jewish community, and whenever they would find Jew people, and they would send them there. So that's why what father of this girl decided, that he was having an office. He decided that let's go for hiding. Chupte hain. Fine. So they, what they did, they went into hiding, clear? And they were not alone. The family of Anne Frank and Eliza Frank, her father, mother, elder sister, and there were total 30 people. You can take notes of this, you will be reading. Total 30 people were there. They just went into hiding in the office of Otto Frank. We will be reading the detailed instructions. And that was not a hiding bit of a day. That was not a hiding of 2 days. It was for years. Can you imagine people, a group of people living at one basement? They are hiding, and how they will fulfill their basic needs of eating, drinking. They were not supposed to move out. Jaise these days COVID is prevailing, the people who are getting infected, they have to seclude themselves for 15 days. So unko 15 days bhi itna mushkil lag raha hai, ki how we can go for hiding for 15 days? We are not supposed to meet anyone. But at least we are having television, we are having phone, we are having video calls, we are having friends and family who can support us. But Anne Frank and her family and other people, they were not having any entertainment source with them. It is the time of the pre-era, when they were not, technology was not that vast, clear? So they went into hiding for years, and she started feeling depressed. So Anne Frank decided, I would be writing diary. Then she started writing diary. That was the decision made by her, okay? So let's read how much time we are having. Let me see. It's till 11:25, okay, fine. So we are having approximately 10 to 12 minutes. Let's start reading. Everybody can see the from the book only. And I would be checking if you are listening to me or not. I would be asking questions. Annalisa Mary Anne Frank, 12 June 1929 to February or March 1945. Because they don't know the month exactly. That's why beta Feb or March. She died in 1945. See, and how famous she became after her death, that we would be reading. Clear? She was born in, this is the birth date, 12th June 1929. and she died in Feb or March 1945. She was a German-born Jewish girl. Underline this. She was born in Germany, but she was a Jewish girl who wrote while in hiding with her family and four friends in Amsterdam during the German occupation of the Netherlands in World War II. Clear? World War II was going on. And she was born in Germany, but she was a Jewish girl hailing from Jewish community. And she started writing while she was hiding with her family and friends in Amsterdam. Fine. When that German occupation of the Netherlands means when they were invaded, at that time she started writing. Her family had moved to Amsterdam after the Nazis gained power in Germany. You know, when you will read about, you might have read about Nazis' invasion in Germany in your social sciences also. If you have not read beta, you just search on Google about Nazis in Germany. You will get a fair idea. Then you will be able to relate this chapter clearly. Okay. Tomorrow I will be asking if any one of you have read. So as persecutions against the Jewish populations increased, it means when they started, you know, doing harm to Jewish community, when they were finding Jewish population, wherever they were searching these girls, boys, men, women, old people from Jewish community, they started persecuting them. They started, you know, they were being killed. They were being sent to concentration camps. When it increased, the family went into hiding in July 1942 in hidden rooms in her father Otto Frank's office building. So then they decided ki now the torture is being increased. We cannot survive this. So father decided ki let's move to hiding in Amsterdam and the office of Otto Frank. Clear? Underline, this is very important. July 1942. Clear? After 2 years in hiding, the group was betrayed and transported to the concentration camp system where Anne died of typhus. Underline. Typhus ko underline karo. See, for 2 long years, that family and other people were under hiding. They lived very tough life. They breathed under very tough circumstances. Sometimes they were not even able to get proper meal. They were not able to get proper sleeps. Even then they spent 2 years, but even after 2 years, they got captured by Nazis. They were sent to concentration camps, and they are the open places, you know, where they were not being getting any facilities. There she died. Her health deteriorated and she died of typhus. Now, what is typhus? Typhus is an infectious disease. Typhus is an infectious. Corona is also infectious. You can get from one person to another. Similarly, this was infectious that can be captured from one to another person. So she got this infection, typhus. That infection, spread in her body and she died out of it in Bergen-Belsen within days of her sister Margaret Frank. Her father Otto Frank, the only survivor, not only Anne Frank died, her whole family died along with all the friends and all. Only Otto Frank, he could survive. Otto Frank, now you tell me. Let me check. Jia Dhawan, can you unmute yourself? Who's Otto Frank? Jia Dhawan? The ones who will not give response, they are absent from me. It means they are not there. Nobody will be raising hand. I would be asking to in between. Jia Dhawan has not given answer. So the question moves to Saksham Grover. Unmute yourself. Saksham Grover, unmute yourself. Might be busy in completing the holidays homework, no? Those who want answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Jia Dhawan, beta. Who was Otto Frank?
Some father.
Whose father?
Annie.
Anne Frank's father.
Wow.
Okay, you can mute yourself. Shahad. Okay, Daksh, you can unmute yourself. Daksh, unmute yourself. Yes, Daksh. For how long they stayed in hiding? For how many years they stayed in hiding? Daksh, boliye. Vivan Kumar, yes, beta.
2 years.
2 years, very good. Those who are giving answers, they are present. Those who are not even unmuting, they are absent for me. Very easy question I'm asking. Okay. Srishti, unmute yourself. Srishti, unmute yourself. Harsimran is saying 4 years. I have not discussed this a long span till now, but I'm just checking whether you are paying attention or not. Sam, unmute yourself, Sam.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta. How did Anne Frank die?
Through an infectious communicable disease, typhus.
Typhus, very good. You can mute yourself. Fine. So I was just checking that whether you are paying attention or not. Okay. So just away. Only 5 minutes are left. Let's continue. So we have read that when they decided ki they will be moving to Father Otto Frank's office in the building. Clear? After 2 years in hiding, the group was betrayed and transported to the concentration camp system. So they were forced to go there and they died of typhus in Bergen-Belsen within days of her sister Margot Frank. So her sister also died. She also died. Her father was the only survivor of the group. Whosoever was there in the concentration camp, they all died. Only Otto Frank survived. So he returned to Amsterdam after the war ended. So when World War II ended, after years, he returned to his native place, Amsterdam, where they were hiding in that office building, to find that her diary had been saved. He found a diary. He was not knowing that his daughter had been writing or had been recording the daily life which they survived over there for 2 years. Convinced that it was a unique record, he took action to have it published in English under the name The Diary of a Young Girl. Underline this, Vita. See the emotions of a father when he saw the diary written by her late daughter who died in that concentration camp of typhus. He decided that my daughter has written beautifully. Nobody might have noted down what we did under those hiding days when they were hiding in that office. So he thought I should get it published. The diary was given to Anne Frank for her 13th birthday and chronicles the events of her life from 12th June 1942 until its final entry of 1st August 1944. When did she receive that diary? Everybody, beta, your now papers are quite objective based. You should know all the details. You will be giving your Google form tests also, subjective tests also, and your test starts from next week onwards. Fine. Maybe this week also you might be having tests. So diary was a gift actually when she became 13-year-old and she started writing in that diary from 12th June 1942 until final entry was made on 1st August 1944. So it took 2 years almost, you can underline. It was eventually translated from its original Dutch. Beta, now what is the language of a German country? People speak Germany over there, and Dutch language also. Being Jewish, she was proficient in that language, Dutch. She wrote the diary in that language, but it got translated into many languages and it became one of the world's most widely read books. There have also been several movies, films, television and theatrical productions, and even an opera. Opera is a singing beta when they tell the story while singing. You might have seen, you have seen Ramayana, hum katha sunate hain, hum Ram ki katha sunate hain, ga ke. Fine, while singing, that is a kind of opera only, when you sing a story. So this book became so famous that there were a lot of theatrical productions, opera, movies, based on this diary, described as the work of a mature and insightful mind. See, because it was considered writing as if a mature person was writing. Insightful means a person who's having knowledge. The diary provides an intimate examination of daily life under Nazi occupation. So when they were invaded by Nazis, how they spent their every day, every hour, she noted down in the crux form. Anne Frank has become one of the most renowned, renowned means famous, and discussed of the Holocaust victims. So she became very famous out of it. Clear? We are not left with much time. So now, doubts. If you have any doubts so far, you can ask me, beta. If you could not understand about 13-year-old girl's life, we would be reading about her first diary tomorrow, because time is not there with us. I just told you she named her diary Kitty, and she was 13-year-old when she started writing. On her 13th birthday, she got this diary. Her father Otto Frank, mother Edith Frank, sister Margot Frank. Divyansh, you can send me personally, beta. Those who are having any confusions, you send me your homework individually, but from the number which is with me. Don't send from unknown numbers. And don't forget to rename your PDFs, okay, as I have already circulated in the group. Okay. That we would be reading, Tanya. Tanya, we would be reading about how Otto Frank survived tomorrow. Okay, we are not left with time. It's already 11:25, so meeting is automatically going to cut off. Fine. So we would be reading about Otto Frank. We would be reading about how he survived, how he got it published, and what happened afterwards tomorrow. Okay, so well, be in touch. Well in time. Okay, beta? Have a good day.